you so much for giving me a hearty congratulations on the recent award of the ELA seed grant, which is focusing on the initiatives for the evidence use and curation. My project will focus on developing a guideline for use by government agency NAFDAC, Info National Agency for Food, Drug and Administration Control in Nigeria, to facilitate their mandate where they oversee importation, distribution, sales, use of medical devices, drugs, food, prepackaged water in the country. It's a huge space that if we can capture in the message we have concerning evidence creation and use, it will really turn around millions of lives in Nigeria and the region going, looking at the bigger picture. What I've done so far, following the main workshop here in Kenya, has been participating in African Science Week in Zambia. Although this event was sponsored by NEST Einstein Forum, because I just became a fellow, so they asked me to go co-organize the event and serve as a resource person as well in Zambia. So it was a week-long event, and I saw it as an opportunity to push evidence to that market. So we had different forms of audience, ranging from local people who use these evidences in different ways, and then the students. We had the primary school students, the high school, also the university students, and also the researchers, young PhD students and faculty members. So we had different ways of, you know, bringing them together to understand what evidence, amidst others, celebrating science as a whole. That's the essence of this African Science Week, celebrating science in the African region. But we also pushed in the need for the students to focus on the kind of research that's been produced. Because by and large, evidence creation and use would depend largely on the validity of such research created and the availability. So we had interactions, discussions around what makes research valid and available. So also back home in Nigeria, I've been interacting with a lot of researchers about evidence creation and use. And sometime last month, I found the opportunity to organize all the females in Faculty of Science. So all female science students, I put them together. I invited the Vice Chancellor of my university, University of Port Harcourt. I also invited the Dean, Faculty of Science, the Research Office in my university, and the head of department of some of the departments in the faculty. And they graced that occasion. And in that occasion, we tried to work on the students. So we termed it Waking the Science in Young Minds. So the science is already there, the science student, we try to wake them up. Why are you here? So whence are you here? And what made you come here? So we block them in groups, and it's really amazing that a lot of them are not sure why they came there. So we try to have specific information for different groups, different clusters. Those who came there because their parents wanted them to be scientists because somehow it's famous to be scientists, and some who said they've watched some scientists, they have role models they're looking up to, and they decided to be scientists. Then try to find out also whether they are screwed up in being science students. So, okay, you had a lot of expectations, you came in. Are you screwed up or are you happy? So we had different groups. And I tried to tell them there is hope for all of the groups. So if we can key into what we are set to do as scientists, they are students, that we want to add to the society, want to use the systematic studies which science employs to add to development. And if we're doing these systematic studies, that we have to have in mind what aspect of human life that we're targeting on. So that's why you have different aspects of science, you say life sciences, you say okay, environmental sciences, you say physical sciences, all aspects. So what next? What do you do with the science you create? For right from the undergraduate studies or the postgraduate studies, as the cases may be, what are you targeting to do? Just to bag a degree or to add value to the system you met? So you must have to change something or bring something new on board. We talked about innovation. So they were excited that they want to be part of the developmental journey, bringing evidence that can help to make informed decisions. You know, in development works, like the evidence cascading, we need a lot of funds. So you do a lot of things with money. The country is so big, like targeting my country, Nigeria, is a very big one. So navigating the nooks and crannies of the country is a lot of money. You also need to help us with advertisement, pushing out to the media so they can target all the channels that people regularly visit. Also partnering with academies, which you're already doing with the African Academy of Science and our National Academy, okay, to see how they can make these topical issues in their daily discussion. So if you give us push, so we work from the other angle, you work from this other angle, we have a meeting point. Also providing resources in terms of materials, training, workshop. We can get people together and bring you in to come help us train them. You know, sometimes familiarity becomes redundancy. So when people continually get trained by people they know, sometimes it looks like brain same diminishing return. So we'd like you to also infiltrate new knowledge, new person, new organization into the Nigerian space. I was also interacting with you, your team, yesterday, thinking about having your presence in West Africa. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would be also very nice. We want to have more organizations focusing on evidence. Right now, we don't have a lot of calls on evidence. So we want to see more organizations joining the team. And when we try to produce the evidence and try to engage the policymakers and the buying into it, we'll like you to project the outcomes, project them for us so other government agencies can find the need to buy in into the evidence space. So it's not going to be easy, but I can tell you that it's a new area that is really relevant because you will see it. People like to see, to believe what they see. So when the evidences are being used to make decisions or to make policies, I think we see the outcome in how the society will get transformed. This is the changes we want to see as scholars, as champions of evidence that you are championing now for us to come up. So also, I like you to apply for more funding for us. We are going to create proposals as scholars and researchers, but in our faculty members, we have a lot of work outside this, so we have less time to channel into finding money. But I can tell you that we have a network already of scholars who are very globally minded, who will take on the initiatives of evidence. So we'd like you to provide more funding so we can get more people trained, because the work is enormous, but the actors are very few. So we need to grow more capacity, and then I think the job will get lighter.